statement provided up to the period of March 15th, the library was fairly bland, which is why I criticised it last time, why I raised concerns. I'm sorry, I think some members were here, but Adrian was here. However, our difficulty is knowing what we know subsequently, and of course the criticisms and issues that have been raised subsequently. I, last time, said I couldn't agree with what was being put forward as a picture till March, whatever, March 2016, so voted against the last committee. Members may sort of reluctantly accept the picture up to March 2016, because we have a vote on whether that element is acceptable or not, because it appears in the annual accounts later on. The terms then become what we say about the developments subsequent and how we frame that once we've dealt with the issue of the first vote and whether it's all right till March 16th. I'm sorry, this is heavy weather, so I'll try. But subsequently, the committee should, has recognised, that information that has received subsequently, development since, thrown new light on the matters covered in the report and believes that these should be addressed. And I believe it would land like that.
That's a very likely way, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I don't want to sit on this committee, but it strikes me if you look at the appraisal situation, appraisals are not worth the paper they're written on, they don't highlight weaknesses. And obviously, trying to keep to a time scale of 30th September is a moot point if the appraisals don't show the accuracy of the appraised.
think that's a very honourable position to take.
It is. Can I suggest that with that on that basis, we ask the
Yeah.